Ever wondered what bones of the upper limb can be tricky to correctly pronounce? Continue watching to learn the list of seven bones in the upper limb that are the most difficult to pronounce. And to make things even more interesting, we'll be reviewing some relevant information about each of these bones. By the end of this video, you'll be able to master pronunciation of some of the trickiest anatomical terms for the bones of the upper limb. First on the list, we have the humerus. The humerus is the longest and largest bone of the upper limb. It consists of a proximal end, a shaft, and a distal end, all of which contain important anatomical landmarks. The humerus articulates with the scapula proximally at the glenohumeral joint, so it participates in the movements of the shoulder. In addition to that, the humerus has distal articulations with the radius and the next bone that made the list, the ulna. The ulna is a long bone that helps stabilize the antebrachial region from the medial side of the forearm. Its proximal end consists of the following two processes and two notches. The olecranon, a hook-shaped process located on the posterior aspect of the proximal ulna end. The trochlear notch, which is a C-shaped notch, located anterior to the olecranon. It articulates with the trochlea of the humerus at the elbow joint. The coronoid process is an eminence that projects forward from the upper and front part of the ulna, and the radial notch is the articular facet of the radio-ulna joint which can be found on the lateral aspect of its head. We're now moving further distally to the hand and the wrist, where we find a lot of bones with names that are hard to pronounce. Like this one, the scaphoid. The scaphoid bone is the largest carpal bone of the proximal row, and it lies beneath the anatomical snuff box. From a palmar view, it is surrounded on the proximal side by the radius, on the distolateral side by the trapezium bone, and on the distomedial side by the trapezoid bone. Superior medially, it articulates with the lunate bone, and inferomedially with the capitate bone. On the palm of the hand, its tubercle is easily palpable as it sits subcutaneously. The next bone on our list is the hamate. The last of the eight carpal bones and the distal row is the hamate bone. It is subcutaneously palpable due to the hamulus, which is a bony notch on its palmar aspect and curves laterally. It assists in aid of the flexor digiti minimi brevis and the pisohamate ligament. The hamate bone is surrounded from a proximolateral direction by the lunate bone and a proximomedial direction by the triquetral bone. Laterally, it communicates with the capitate bone, and distally, it articulates with both the fourth and fifth metacarpal bones. Another bone that has a tricky name is the triquetrum, also known as the triquetral bone. The triquetrum is shaped like a pyramid, and, from a palmar perspective, its apex points distomedially towards the pisiform bone, which is positioned upon its palmar facet. It sits upon the hamate bone, which is in the distal row of carpal bones, and its base faces laterally and communicates with the lunate bone. Next bone in our list is the capitate. The capitate bone is the largest of all the carpal bones, both proximally and distally. It is surrounded by the lunate bone proximally, the third metacarpal bone distally, the trapezoid bone laterally, and the hamate bone medially. The last bone in our list is the pisiform. The pisiform bone is the most medial proximal carpal bone from a palmar stance. It is also the smallest of all the carpal bones and classified as a sesamoid bone. Its dorsal structure is faceted, allowing it to articulate with the ventral surface of the triquetral bone. It is palpable and lies within the tendon of the flexor carpi ulnaris. And that's it! We've covered the seven most difficult to pronounce bones in the upper limb. Hopefully this video will give you more confidence when talking about any of these structures.
Knowing how to pronounce these terms is one of the many things you need to do when learning human anatomy. So you're not done yet. Continue learning with our fun videos, interactive quizzes, detailed articles, and stunning atlas connected to these terms. Click on the button to find everything you need to become a master in human anatomy.